Hey everyone! Digital Factory uses our patent-pending single-pass underbase and highlight white technology. In this video, we'll give a general overview of underbase and highlight white, and we'll also take a look at how to set up the single-pass underbase and highlight white feature in the RIP. Traditionally, underbase and highlight white printing is often used with DTG and UV printers using layers. On most printers, you first print the underbase layer with white, then you rewind the printer and print the colors with highlight white. Highlight white prints only on white pixels and helps boost the white. Most DTF machines cannot rewind and therefore have white limitations. With industry standard technology printing, the most common configuration is CMYK plus white, which results in unsatisfactory white coverage, especially in highlights. With that configuration, a second pass to print more white ink is not possible. Now with single pass highlight white and underbase printing technology, Fiery's patent pending technology provides the whitest whites, most vibrant colors, and reduces print time without the need for a second pass. This can give you more white coverage in highlighted areas, potentially reaching maximum coverage, resulting in significant visual improvements. The additional coverage is dependent on the film, ink, and percentage of underbase being used. Here are two samples to demonstrate the difference using white underbase technology. The original on the left, and using the highlight white on the right at 100%. This sample will be used to show the underbase and highlight white feature. Before the file is imported, a new print mode using the new underbase and highlight white feature needs to be created. For this demonstration, the Oddly 24 DTF printer is being used, but it can be any printer that uses white ink. You can either amend an existing print mode by going to the Devices menu, selecting Manage Print Modes, and then editing the print mode, or you can select a print mode on the bottom right. In this case, 720 by 1200 color opaque is selected. Go to the Q menu and select Properties or double-click on the Q tab. In the Q Properties dialog, select Processing Options in the Color Layer group on the left. By default, the White Underbase Highlight option is set to Underbase to generate the White Underbase for inkjet printers. The Maximum Ink Percentage, or White Ink Strength, defines how much white is printed. To the right is a tick box for Underbase and Highlight. When selected, the Highlight White Strength option appears. You can independently define how much underbase and how much highlight white to print. The idea of highlight white is to create a bright, opaque white in the white areas of the design. In this case, setting the highlight white to 100% achieves that result. Keep the underbase at 50 to 60% to avoid white bleeding into the colors. Click on Create Print Mode. Name the new print mode, 720 by 1200 color opaque, 100 highlight, and click Save. Then click OK. Select the new print mode on the bottom right and import the file. The queue is set to mirror the file for DTF output. Right-click on the job in the queue and select Rip Only. Once the file has been ripped, right-click on the job again and this time select View Raw Data to view the output. In the View Raw Data preview, you can see a difference in the white, especially when you view all colors as black and deactivate CMYK planes. The gray in the preview is the underbase. The black is the underbase and highlight. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, hit the like button, and if you have any questions, please reach out to us at any time. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos covering Digital Factory products.